When discussing the drug which shall not be named, I don't want to just talk about that it works. I want to discuss how it works. And for that, I turn to this evidence-based review. There is a lot discussed in this study, so I'm just going to go over a few key points. Free binding energy of the spike protein was higher than with remdesivir. And this executes the antiviral efficiency by disrupting the binding.
Disrupting the binding? What does that mean?
Well, it basically bound to the S protein, making it unavailable to bind to the CD147.
Kinda like a condom. I mean, if it's covered, it can't bind.
Not only that, but it suppressed signaling to the IL-6 gene, which is responsible for cytokine storm. Dramatically reduced. And it did this by using its anti-inflammatory action, significantly reducing mucus goblet cells. Probably the most significant part of the study that I found was the fact that it improves cardiac function. And considering SARS-CoV-2 causes myocarditis, improving your cardiac function is probably a good thing.